So in this respect, people like you, being only an author, being only a writer, have a tremendous responsibility in giving us stories which can help us to find grounding in our time.
Yes, for instance, what Dita said about, and you said also, about so-called human nature, mm-hmm. what really it is. This is the question for you, George, because you are an expert as a religious man. But I would expect from the science to say something about it, to be very carefully research really in all, you know, on many fields. What's going on with human nature? Is it true that altruism is so important, that we are not competitive beings, but rather altruistic one? How it is with all those excluded groups, like women, for instance? What is their role in the history and the building of society? And all those things which sometimes we treat as obvious, but they are not so obvious. And my point of view as a writer is always looking for eccentricity. So try to think not like everybody used to think. Try to find the different points of view and look from outside.
I want to reassure you, because what I want to tell you is that science and literature, or science and art, are very, very similar. Many people make great distinctions and so on, but the thought process is that science is led by methodological advance. So we had to know about DNA to be able to produce sequences, to be able to provide information which allowed us to overturn a previous knowledge mm-hmm. into a current knowledge, which is equally fragile. Knowledge is always fragile. Why is it fragile? Because we live in a very dynamic world, very interactive world, a much bigger world, 2.5 billion at the beginning of the century, last century, 7.8 billion at the moment. It's dynamical. And second, it is not context-free. Mm-hmm. So when the context changes, be it for methodological reason, for a social reason, for a reason of a change in religious understanding, then our interpretation of the world changes. Mm-hmm. Just as the change in medical knowledge has changed our approach to pandemics. And we're much better. We've only got, 250,000 dead this time, not 50 million. So we're dealing with complex systems by looking for that which is different, because the tendency is always to regress to the mean. So every scientist, every thinker, every literary person is always looking for what is different in order to be able to progress. The need to progress is brought about by social change, demographic change, geographical change, change in the weather.